sorghum could give us more than just food for our cattle. It can grow in drought conditions, and it can grow with very minimal water, and then it would be able to grow as high as 14 feet with that very minimal water. That's a lot of biomass for very little input.
My research involves the optimization of genetic transformation of the cereal crop sorghum for maximizing its potential as a bioenergy crop.
This usually involves introducing genes into the plant to improve its traits, and our research involves adding these genes that have been borrowed from wheat. And these genes have been shown to improve that regeneration efficiency. So regeneration when that plant, during transformation, starts to transition into either a shoot or a root. Because sorghum doesn't have the best ability to regenerate in the plant tissue culture, but we have seen that these genes specifically allow for regeneration in wheat. So we thought that when we introduce this foreign wheat gene into the sorghum, sorghum might have this better ability that it didn't have. So that's basically what we wanted to do, improve its traits for plant transformation.
And not only is it useful as a source for the bioproducts and biofuels, but this genetic transformation research
is useful not only for plant or crop science, but the techniques that we find from this type of research could also be applied
to other branches of science as well. And I find that very exciting because I really feel like we're getting there. I feel like this transformation of sorghum would be something that you don't even have to wait a full year just to get a result from. I really do see the potential of sorghum as the bioenergy crop that could potentially help with our energy crisis.
Studying something so basic like that and then being able to convert that into something useful and actually something that we absolutely need right now, it's very rewarding.